Hello everyone, this is Rajiv and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And today we are going to talk about a very important aspect of PowerPoint shapes, and that is the freeform shapes and how you can find the vertex and node information of a freeform shape if you want to manipulate them either by VBA, or you can also use C# if you are interested in developing VSTO PowerPoint add-ins, or you can also use PowerPoint JavaScript API if you are interested in developing a Microsoft PowerPoint Office add-in. So let's get started and let me show you this presentation here. I have included the link of this presentation in the video description. You can go and download. And let me draw a freeform shape here. So after drawing this shape, if I press Alt+F8 key to execute a macro, or you can also turn on the developer tab from the Office Ribbon Customization option found inside the File, Options, and here you can go to Customize Ribbon and scroll down and you can turn on developer, and from the developer you can also run the macros. However, the macros are also available in the View section. So here I select this display freeform shape details refined macro and run this macro, and I have created a form here which will display the selected shape information, specifically the freeform selected shape information. And here you can see that we have found the vertices and the nodes information of the freeform shape, and you can see that it is showing us total 7 nodes in the freeform shape. And let me also turn on shape format, edit shape, edit points, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And in the object properties you can see it is showing total 7 nodes instead of 5. So why it is doing this I will explain you later. Let me draw another shape here. Insert shape, and this time let us draw only 3 nodes, and let's see the object properties again. You can see that it has correctly identified that number of nodes are 3, and their exact position in the points and in the pixels. Let me show you the VBA script. Alt+F11 to open the VBA for PowerPoint. And here you can see that I have created the form which will include the detailed shape information about its vertices and nodes. And here we have module 1 that is fetching the nodes and vertices of the selected freeform shape. So once you have this information, then surely you can manipulate the shapes. Let me test this one. And you can see that it has created a new shape with the new dimension after manipulating the selected shape. This was just for testing purposes only. So let me show you another thing here, animation manager. And here now I select this freeform shape, and you can see that how I am using the information, the vertices and the nodes information inside my PowerPoint VSTO add-in. And here I am going to click on the storyboard settings button, and here you can see that it has accurately find out that where each of the node is on the screen and inside the PowerPoint presentation and on the slide. So I am calculating everything relative to each other, and vice versa as well. Like I am sending the detailed information about the nodes and the vertices from the PowerPoint add-in to WPF application, which is overlapping this WPF UI over the selected freeform shape. So I can also modify these nodes now by holding this new ellipse over the edit points. So if I now drag and drop, you can see that it is updating the shape in real time. So that is how you can use the selected shape information to better manipulate the shape and the animations. So this was just for testing purposes, and let me show you one of my another project here. Let me tell you one more thing, that the PowerPoint works in the point system, whereas the WPF application works in the pixel system. And if I click on the object properties, then you can see that I am here noting down the information of each node in both the points and in the pixels, and sending this to the WPF application. So we can process the information in both type of units. So let me initialize the selected shape again with the new nodes and vertices. So one more thing that I would like to tell you here, that I am showing you this the information about the pixels and points because the polylines and the red ellipse that you are seeing over the shapes are not inside the PowerPoint, but they are overlaid over the freeform shape. So let's say if I minimize the PowerPoint, then you can see that they are actually overlaid over the screen, and we are calculating the exact position of the nodes according to the PowerPoint and according to the WPF screen specific position. So let me show you one more interesting thing here. Later we will embed this UI inside our WPF application's main window, and we have already make our main window as the child window of PowerPoint. So then this problem will also get resolved, that it will not overlay. We have already implemented many UIs as the child object of the PowerPoint. Like another UI I have is the custom rotation point. So it is also overlaid, but you can see that as I have minimized the PowerPoint window, the custom rotation point is also minimized along with the PowerPoint window. So now let me show you the logs, that so you can know that how this information works. So here we have the storyboard settings window logs. Let me close this shape overlay window. And here you can see that after clicking the storyboard button, it initializes the selected shape and get the data of the nodes and the vertices sent by the PowerPoint add-in by the named pipes. And here you can see that as I have moved the mouse and the ellipse after dragging it and start moving around, and lastly I drop that at a specific position on the screen, so then it updated the position with the new coordinates of each of the node and each of the vertices. And let me show you my class library log, the comb helper, which is actually updating the shape in the real time. And here you can see that how it has updated from the original position to the updated position for the selected node. So this is my another implementation that I tested on the freeform shape. And now if I select this shape and then click on the storyboard settings button, so this is the earlier implementation, and the red ellipse that I have shown you, that is the new implementation. And earlier we were showing the ellipse and the polylines in this WPF application window, but now we are showing the polylines and the ellipse over the shape itself. So once you have the information, what I meant to say is, once you have the exact information, then you can surely manipulate everything like this. So we also have our earlier implementation of the spin animation. So if I further include the spin animation with this jumping lines, so you can see the effect. So everything is updating in real time. However, as the comb usage is expensive, so it is a bit lagging. I will improve the efficiency of this, as there are around 7 nodes which are getting manipulated in real time, so that is why a little bit lag here, and it is also become a little difficult to select the running shape here, but I find this interesting here. Lastly, in my earlier videos I have shared with you that how we can also identify a partial selected group, like a shape selected within from the group. And here you can see that we have included the details of the group along with the group ID, and is partially selected true for this rectangle 9 shape. And I have also shared the VBA script with you. So what I am going to tell you is that once you have the exact information about the selected shapes, then surely you can manipulate them. Like after fetching this partial selected group information, I have applied the animation to an individual selected shape within from the group like this. And now I can also rotate any of the another shape as well. So that was not already possible in PowerPoint. Not only that, I can also now spin the entire group as well. And later I can also include new shapes within this group, and we can also remove the shapes within from a group as well. However, I will make it more smooth, as the entire group will start rotating, then they have to follow the same positions and the same smoothness as the entire group start spinning. Now you can see that they lag a bit when the entire group starts spinning. However, just with the information, I successfully applied different animation to the individual shapes within the group. So I hope you will find this interesting, and don't forget to like, share and comment. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye and take care.